네, 축구 인생 최고의 감동이었다. 2002년 한일 월드컵 4강 신화를 이끈 우리들의 명장이죠. 거스 히딩크 전 감독을 모셨습니다. 반갑습니다.
Thank you.
오실 때마다 많은 팬들이 반겨주시는데 좀 어떠신지?
I feel very joyful. I feel a lot of respect from the people still after, let's say, 20, 22 years. When I come back, and almost every year we come back, then I feel a lot of friendship, even by people who were not even born in 2002. Yeah.
당시 응원가가 혹시 기억나시나요?
You can sing it.
대한민국.
Yeah, of course.
하실 수 있다고 우리말로 하실 수.
대한민국, yeah, of course, yeah.
올 초에는 이제 뭉쳐야 찬다에 출연하시기도 하셨잖아요. 2002년 월드컵의 주역 선수들을 만나기도 하셨는데 어떠셨나요?
And I remember, of course, An Jung-won was there.
An Jung-won.
And Kim Nam-il was there.
Yeah.
But as a surprise, on top of that, Park, what I call always Park Ko-chi.
Park Hang-seo.
Yeah, he came also. Later in this show, and that was for me quite a surprise.
혹시 가장 기억에 남는 순간이 있으실까요?
Then you get your memories back from the performances of Kim Nam-il, who was for me and for the team a very good midfield player who kept always the balance in the team, and everybody knows the story about An Jung-won. At the end. He made crucial decisions with his goals, so it was a great memory for all of us.
그러면 혹시 손흥민이나 이강인 선수, 뭐 김민재 선수 같이 해외 리그에서 활약하는 선수들은 혹시 보신 적 있으신가요?
Yeah, of course, because what I just said, I can't see the Korean matches in the Korean league, but of course in Europe there are now Korean players playing, and I think that's a good signal of how Korean football has developed itself. So there are good players playing in big clubs, and that's recognized in Europe as well.
손흥민 선수는 우리나라 국가대표팀과 토트넘 주장을 맡고 있기도 한데 혹시 그 리더십에 대해서 평가할 만한 점이 있으실까요?
Well, it's amazing how he is taking the leadership. In the Korean team, I think it's rather normal with his way of playing and his status in Korea. But it's not normal to have the leadership also taken in Tottenham, because that's, and I worked in England also in certain periods. Normally they take players also from their own country or very established European players. But the way that he is leading this team now, it's worth a lot of respect from my side. It's not easy to be a captain of a team, but he showed that he has all the capacity to do so.
우리 한국 축구가 최근에 크고 작은 위기를 겪기도 했는데 앞으로 좀 더 성장하려면 어떤 점이 좀 필요하다고 보시는지 궁금합니다.
Generally spoken, and I think they do now, to have a good education system in all the clubs, all the professional clubs. Have always the intention, of course, for the first team, how they perform, but on a main trail must be the education of young players that every time.
지금 대한민국 축구 대표팀은 다음 이제 감독을 누가 맡을지가 매우 관심인데 어떤 자질을 갖춘 감독이 지금 필요하다고 보시나요?
What does the coach have to do is select the best players you have available, and then create the atmosphere that everyone. Feels recognized and everyone respects each other, and that everyone knows what to do, what his job is inside the pitch, and how to behave outside the pitch. That's the atmosphere as the coach has to create that atmosphere.
며칠 전에 제가 이영표 선수를 인터뷰했을 때 이영표 선수가 뭐라고 했냐면 경기장에 나가기 전에 내가 오늘 이겨야지 이런 생각보다 오늘은 내가 경기장에서 감독님을 위해 죽어야겠다. 이런 마음을 들게 해준 감독님이라고 말씀을 하시더라고요, 이영표 선수가. 그렇게 선수들을 좀 수평적이면서도 그렇게 장악할 수 있었던 비결이 어디에 있다고 보시나요?
There are no secrets. There are no secrets. The only aim I had is to get the best out of every player, whether they are 30 or whether they are 20, 21, whatever, on their position. So I tried to get the best out of the players. Also, helping each other. It's not that they have to perform well, but they have to help each other as well. So It's not just it's just a matter of age. It's a matter of giving the best. And Yongpyo, very intelligent player, I think he phrased it well by saying that everyone was equal in the position.
지난 2021년에 이제 지도자로서 은퇴를 선언하셨는데 혹시 아쉽진 않으신가요?
Yeah, of course. Oh, yeah, of course. I am retired partly, but still I'm involved with a lot of young coaches, which every now and then I talk to, male and female coaches, to share experience. Mm. Sometimes I'm looking to a training session from those coaches, and I must say that I sometimes have the urge to step in onto the pitch. I have the urge, but I have to control myself.
거스 히딩크 재단을 만들어서 직접 그 꿈나무들을 키우고 계신데 시각장애인들을 위한 풋살 구장을 만든다든지 이런 활동들을 또 많이 하고 계시더라고요.
It's very important that handicapped kids, but also sight impaired kids have the possibility to practice, because playing football or sports is very beneficial for kids. So I had always a life with a lot of movement and a lot of joy seeing kids growing up and helping them to grow through sports, any sports. Mm. So that's why it was founded, and not to develop talented players. Mm. It was just for giving opportunities to disabled and in this case sight impaired children.
Mm. 앞으로 혹시 또 다른 계획들이 있으신지 궁금합니다.
What I said, I'm guiding some coaches in Holland, over in Europe. That's what I like. That's what I like. And furthermore, being healthy for the upcoming time. I don't know how long, but I hope to be a long time in good condition. And every now and then coming back to Korea.
한국 팬들에게 마지막으로 인사 한마디 좀 남겨주실까요?
Yeah, I hope the Korean fans will enjoy the current national team as well as they did the older generation, as they did in 2002. That was a tremendous party in all the country. And this team has good players, and I think they will qualify for the World Cup in 26 as well. So we can enjoy a very courageous Korean team.
오늘 말씀 여기까지 듣겠습니다. 우리들의 명장 히딩크 감독과 함께했습니다. 고맙습니다.
We finished the interview?
Yeah.
Okay. Maya, thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
It's a great honor to meet you.
Thank you.